Hey guys, Decaf13 here, and welcome back to some more Let's Play Shin Megami Tensei 4 Apocalypse. In the last episode, we continued making our way through the Cosmic Egg, and we ended up fighting two more key figures of the Divine Powers. We ended up fighting Inanna and rescuing Toki from her, as well as Mitra Buddha. And we defeated them both. Now we can actually, I haven't checked my Cathedral Shadows app in a while. What can't we fuse? Deity Ball, Tyrant Beelzebub, Deity Apsu, Vile Seth, Lady Inanna, Deity Maitreya, and Fury Mitra Buddha.
Welcome to the Cathedral of Shadows, where demons dwell.
Oh, there's Maitreya. I need some interesting. Oh, what the fuck is this? Off my screen, Mozilla Firefox. There's Ball. Samyaza. Just missing one. Looks like something. I don't know. I forget what it was called. Alright.
Gather demons!
Let's keep on heading in. The sixth. Is the final. Oh shit. Hey, an item. Need of life. That's always useful.
Not bad.
Something over here. We have over here. The chest. What's in this one? Boring water and 3 summon stones. Yes. Yes, I need those. We all know I need summon stones. Oh, jeez. More items. I guess they just really want to get you prepped for this fight. Oh, just a couple small incenses. Yeah, I guess that might help. I mean, I'm not going to use them, but fuck it. Probably just waste all my incenses before the final boss fight.
Nearly upon us. Listen up, kid.
Dagda leaps out of your smartphone and stands before the group.
We're deep inside the cosmic egg now. Krishna and Flynn should be near. It's nearly dusk. Soon the full moon will rise. There isn't much time left. I need to know, kid. What do you plan to do about the cosmic egg? Will you destroy it and maintain the status quo? Or wield its power and forge a new universe founded upon freedom? Two paths, one choice.
Danu once again emerges from Nozomi and approaches Dagda.
Enough of this, Dagda. The cosmic egg must be destroyed.
That's your solution, Mother.
This world is home to countless deities and just as many different world views. We need to embrace that diversity for the betterment of all life. Only then can humans search for answers where there might otherwise be none, and foster their own growth and development.
Finding their own answers, huh? Well, can't say I disagree with that. Trouble is, everything else you've said is utter nonsense. Embrace the diversity of the deities. Each single idea of theirs is itself toxic. Such narrow-minded views need to be eradicated. Human evolution can only be made possible by casting away their imperfect selves.
You want humans to become gods? Do you have any idea what that would mean?
Gods is just a word, Mother. Point is, humans must become more than human. Whatever word you use, the important thing is that humans answer only to themselves. That they find a future governed by their own free will, as one with the universe. This evolution, this true freedom, it is my gift to humanity. But first, I must erase the deities of old and tear down this broken, aging universe.
Your proposed new world would change what it means to be human. Do you not see that their relationship to others is what makes them human?
Donna was right. I'm half demon, but never stop being human.
Regrettably, I agree with Hallelujah. We samurai exist for the people, for the sake of others. I simply cannot fathom how the existence of others would lead to one's ruin.
I couldn't have put it better myself, brother, even though I was just about to.
Yeah?
Of course! What are you accusing me of?
Being a lazy bum. Nozomi bursts out laughing, amused by Navarre and Hallelujah. Still smiling, Nozomi turns to you.
What about you? What do you think, after all this time with us? Wasn't it rewarding to have each other's backs? Dagda's scheme ignores how important, how meaningful friends can be. It also devalues all that we've accomplished together as friends. If even just one small part of you treasures any of that, then let's stop Dagda.
As Dagda said, we are not perfect. But we came this far. Is it not because we helped one another?
Whatever choice you make, I'll be with you. I need you. I want to become strong with you.
It seems we cannot see eye to eye, Dagda. As much as it pains me, we must end this. I will help destroy the cosmic egg. At all cost.
Have you forgotten what existence once meant for us, Mother? To be the rolling wind itself. To be the rain falling upon the earth. Look at us now. Pure nature, forced to become Dagda and Danu.
We changed because humanity gained new understanding. Is that really so bad?
That doesn't matter, Mother. This is about how far we've wandered from what we were. The understanding granted humanity is what locked us in these god-shaped shells. The longer we stay like this, the further we get from the essence of what we were. We need to become one with nature again.
I understand how you feel, son. Truly. But I cannot allow you to do this. And if you will not change your mind, I have no choice but to stop you myself.
Can you really not live without others, kid? Can you not fend for yourself? No. You have a hidden strength. The power to find a path where none exists. Don't let sentiment blind you. These so-called friends only hold you back. Join me in my new universe. The time is now. Choose.
What will you do? I'm sorry, Dagda, but we're going to destroy the cosmic egg.
You hear that, Dagda? He won't abandon his humanity. It's over. He does not wish to be alone. He has chosen to live in harmony with others.
Is this what you really want?
Yeah, he's sticking with this universe. With us. Ask all you want. It won't change a thing.
I don't want to get rid of these guys. They're the best.
Just look at all he's been through. Yet, he still wants to remain human. I'm pretty sure his answer is final.
Oh, Dagda's not happy.
So, you won't be my godslayer.
Dagda extends his arm toward you.
Very well, then. The power I gave you, your very life, I'll take it all back.
Dagda clenches his fist. As he does, a strange sensation comes over you. The heat seems to drain from your body. You fall to your knees, unable to move.
No!
Think on what it means to betray me while you stare into the cold abyss of death!
Ah, fuck. Dagda.
Hey, are you well? You're looking rather pale.
It would seem Dagda is no longer supplying you with his power.
You can't control your demons very well without Dagda's power. Demon summoning program isn't working properly either.
This is bad. There's no way he'll survive like this. Isn't there something we can do?
Please keep him occupied. I will take care of this.
We're all counting on you. You need only bear it a little while longer. We'll be by your side until the end.
Yeah, we're not about to let you die.
I can't imagine what you're planning, but I do know that your efforts will be futile. If nothing else, I would have you die quickly so that it is painless.
Reloaded. Good to go.
Fuck. What the hell am I supposed to do against Dagda?
Yeah!
That's not doing much.
I don't understand.
Do nothing. Fuck. Do nothing. Fuck. Do nothing. Shit.
You're in good hands!
Let me show you what my skills can do!
On to new heights!
Well, everyone else seems to be siding with me. They're all protecting me.
That went well.
Oh, fuck. Taking all my shit. Oh, that's really not good. Damn it, Azrael.
Take that.
You alone.
Wasn't effective.
You feel the energy drain from you, leaving you so weak you can't even lift a finger. You wince in pain as Dagda tries to assuage you with her kind words.
Thanks to your efforts, the preparations are now complete. You've done well. Taking Inanna's powers into myself granted me new abilities. This allows me to create Dagda anew.
Oh?
What? Mother, no!
No mother should have to kill her own child. You could not possibly understand the pain. But please, bear in mind, as the Mother Goddess and Earth Goddess, it is my duty to shoulder such burdens.
The entity created by Danu rises, turns to face his mother.
Mother, thank you for creating me. As High King of the Tuatha De, I will strive to bring prosperity to humankind.
Dagda, my reborn son. Free him.
Yes, I know what I must do. I will grant you power, just as my original self did. But I will leave your will intact. Do as you please with the power. I would ask, however, that as a God Slayer, you eliminate the older Dagda, who remains single-minded.
Damn. That's my replacement. A weakling who depends on others.
Oh, man. Yo, prepare to get fucked up, Dagda. Luster candy. Alright. Time has come to stand against Dagda. Oh, not on Odin. Nice. Alright, Trisagion. That didn't do too much. I guess he resists fire. Ooh, nice, Toki.
Take that.
Wasn't effective.
Great.
Happy now? You made the wrong choice. Breaking contract with me could have escaped this shadow. You've discarded the chance to surpass humanity.
No. He simply chose a path he could share with his friends.
How inane. Are you so certain what you want lies at the end of this path? If so, prove it to me, kid.
Intimidating essence emanates from Dagda. Same with a deadly wind. That didn't do too much. Okay, since we have too many chakra pots, let's have Odin use one so we can use Gungnir. I guess he resists magic. I guess I could try using a concentrated Great Logos on him.
Ineffective.
At least Toki's doing a lot of damage. See? I'll have my friends start moving on in soon. What should Great Logos doing against you? I shouldn't have done that. Ooh, 772. Not bad. How much does Darkness do to you, Dagda?
quite a bit. It decreases your defense. Oh, it's alright, Toki. Oh, I didn't get the thing from that.
Wasn't effective.
I have two great chakras. Let's use one. No, you fucking asshole. Dagda, you piece of shit. Denial. Demon was returned to your stuff.
My power is shining through!
Oh, fuck this fight already. Let's see. You know what? Hey, you could be useful, Sarah.
Summon!
Let me show you what my skills can do!
On to new heights!
Leave it to me.
Just keep coming.
I need more training.
Ooh, this is gonna pierce now. After a second. Ooh. Bet you don't like that, Dagda. Hey, he's almost dead anyway. Oh, it pierces with Smurf. Yeah, he's trying that again. Dagda.
Flow and nurture.
All right, now let's leave our magic alone for a while. Well, Dagda's out of the picture now. Look around and see your friends reacting in their own way. Their support gives you courage. You receive new power as a human. Awakened power. I can also choose to learn awakened power at a later time. Strengthens and adds pierce to all attacks. It's so good. I'm gonna get rid of Medirahana myself for it. Honestly, that's great.
Dagda, my reborn son, please, return to life the souls trapped within the cosmic egg. Without them, the cosmic egg cannot hatch, halting the new universe from being made.
I understand.
You can do that?
Of course.
He's the god of knowledge, after all.
I'm Dagda, the most powerful of the two of the day.
Dagda raises his arm skyward. Motes of light begin to spread from his hand. The light spreads, enveloping the souls, and carries them out of the cosmic egg.
The light's carrying the souls back to their physical bodies. Everyone fed to Shesha should be returned to life.
Does that mean you can bring back...
your friend? Yes, I can bring her back.
One of the motes of light settles in front of you. The light pulses, transforming into a familiar shape.
Asahi!
Oh, Asahi! You've come back to us!
Welcome back. You guys! I'm sorry, I...
What are you apologizing for? You saved his life. Stand a little taller.
Thanks. That makes me feel better.
Asahi looks at you, clearly troubled.
Giving up my life for you, Nanashi, felt like a weight had lifted from me. Like I didn't have to worry anymore. I know I'm not as strong as any of you. I was constantly worried that I had no business being around the likes of you. I was afraid I was holding you all back.
Hey, don't worry about...
But I do. I can't help it. That's why, well, after I died, I had no regrets.
You are utterly mistaken!
Navarre confronts Asahi.
I know you cannot see me, but I'm going to say it anyway! You've put yourself down many a time, but I have witnessed you in earnest. You're the kind of person who would risk her life for her fellow in need. Sure, some may say that they would die for a friend. Yet, how many would actually do it? You may not be as strong as the others in battle, but your selflessness knows no bounds. Of that, I'm certain. My voice may not reach you, but my heart is with you.
Navarre turns away from Asahi with a calculated, cool face.
Actually, I can see you now, Ghostface.
What?
That was a great what.
Thank you for the kind words.
Of course.
True strength is knowing your limitations. In that respect, you're ahead of the game. Stop being so hard on yourself, Asahi.
Asahi nods once in agreement.
I really need to get it together, huh? Look, I know I'm average at the most. I'll probably get in the way sometimes, like usual. But I'll always try my best. I just want to be with you all again.
You hand Asahi her goggles.
Thanks, Nanashi. It's good to be home.
A surge of energy courses through Asahi. Asahi has awakened. Greatly strengthens healing magic. Nah, not for now. Asahi straps her goggles back in place.
Alright. How long are you gonna stay here, kid? This egg isn't going to hatch anymore. But there's still work to do.
Dagda's right. There are still loose ends.
Kill Krishna, save Flynn, destroy this damn egg. We've got our work cut out for us.
Yes. Let us end this, once and for all.
Alright. The effects of Mitra's barrier are gone. You can once again choose continue if you die. Oh, so I guess we have good Dagda on our side now. But you know what? I'm going to call it an episode here. So next time on Let's Play Shin Megami Tensei 4 Apocalypse, we are going to go and fight Krishna and save Flynn at long last. But first, I have to go find that piece of shit Azrael. Fucking goddamn lost punch. I'll see you guys later. Bye.